She had 60 seconds to pitch her business to investors and possibly change her life. But instead...
Attention, Ashley. Your pitch has been denied.
If an entrepreneur can't pitch their business, they can't succeed. It's something we see all the time on our show, Elevator Pitch, where entrepreneurs have 60 seconds to pitch. If they don't get an investor's attention after that, they're done for. So we picked four entrepreneurs who failed on the show and teamed them up with world-class experts in pitching so that they and you can make a good impression in the time it takes to ride an elevator. This is Fix My Pitch.
I've never heard about the peas.
Oh, it's not just the pitch. It's the right person, the right product, the right place.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that we've helped the folks that we've seen so far
find
their peas?
Yeah.
Well, let's do it again.
Let's do it again.
Let's watch.
Hi, my name is Arvind, and I'm an AI researcher and founder of Superintelligence. Being an adult is difficult. It requires managing your life, including your personal, work, and financial. Superintelligence is here to make it easy. Superintelligence is a dashboard that integrates all aspects of your life all in a centralized place.
When I was watching Arvind's pitch, all I kept thinking about was, Arvind, smile. I really like Arvind a lot. However, he came off cold.
Superintelligence began as a project and now has grown to 34,000 users with more than 1 million questions asked. I'm no stranger to building apps. When I was 14, I built my first app and it reached over 20 million downloads. I'm here to raise $250,000 for 2.5% and make the world a smarter place and stress-free and simpler for you.
Okay.
I love this guy. I want to help this guy.
We're going to help this guy.
I love this guy. I like he came out with very simple, I mean, this sounds too good to be true. You got my attention.
Mm-hmm.
Being an adult
right.
is difficult. Who is not going to agree with that statement?
My name is Arvind Bengu, and I am the founder of Superintelligence, and Superintelligence is building an AI that helps people live their life day to day. My goal with being on this show is being able to tell the world of what I'm building and being able to help them with their life.
Hey, Arvind, how are you? Tina.
Pleasure to meet you.
Hi.
Hey, Arvind, how are you? Nice to
Pleasure
meet you.
Pleasure to
meet you.
Anthony
Sullivan. Let's start with the positive. What did you think went well?
Kept good composure and good eye contact with the camera.
Mm-hmm. Yep. You also didn't die. Right, you were brave enough to do this. You got in there, you were able to communicate, right? So you're over that hump now.
Yeah.
I mean, it was all in there. We're rooting for you. So now all we need to do is just hone that a little
you
bit.
You got
right?
stage fright. You got 101 stage fright.
Mm-hmm.
And it happens to a ton of people. Big fears in life, spiders, sharks, public speaking. It looks to me, without knowing you, that you're scared. And it forces you to stutter and stop and start thinking. And once you get in your head, but you did get through it, and I love your first line. Out of all the lines I've heard today, adulting is difficult, being
mm-hmm.
an adult is difficult, you have my attention. What I found for me, even if I'm on camera talking to millions of people, just talking to one person,
mm-hmm.
just talking to that guy behind, I'm talking to one person, I get a smile on my face, I know what I'm talking about, I'm having a casual conversation, you know, you want what I've got. And I didn't realize that Superintelligence was the name of the company. I thought Superintelligence was a descriptor.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So we can brains here is
right.
gonna be, it's gonna be she's gonna help you compartmentalize it and I'll help you present. We will meet you in the workshop, all right? And let's get it done. I think Arvind is a case of just relax, you got this. He's a natural born salesman. I just don't think he knows it. I think we can dial Arvind up a little bit. We can get him to smile. So I'm looking forward to working with Arvind.
All right, we're ready for the next person.
Yeah, one more, let's do it.
Hi, my name is William Golton. I'm the founder and inventor behind Pellera Pharmaceuticals, and we're developing a platform medical device coating to prevent up to 99% of antibiotic resistant infections. Our primary indication is as a coating for urinary catheters. Infections from urinary catheters are responsible for 10,000 deaths and a $1.7 billion economic deficit in the American market alone.
William's in a niche category, and niche categories are hard. He's got it. I just don't know if he's actually got it.
We're working hard to help address a major healthcare crisis, and our beachhead market is around $940 million annually. We're looking at a $2 billion AUM based on our three-product pipeline, and we're working hard. We are the future of healthcare and medicine. We are protected by Paldera. Thank you.
Interesting.
I was waiting for him to finish.
He's all over the place.
Right? And that's the thing. He clearly knows what he's talking about. Where's the enthusiasm? Get the peas in there.
Yeah.
Right? Get all of the pieces in there that would answer the questions and pique the curiosity of the investors.
I think body language is, he's almost very defensive.
Yeah.
I personally am a big hand talker. I've got, you know, here's how to order and there's a rhythm to it, right?
I'm overwhelmed. This is my first time in New York. It's an incredible city, but it's a lot all at once, especially coming from a small town in Oklahoma. But I'm really excited about the experience and the opportunity.
Hey, there
it's
we
great
go.
Great to
Hi.
Meet you guys.
Great to meet you.
Great
to
meet you. Yourself. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, and take a seat.
Yeah,
okay,
let's
absolutely.
Go ahead and take
Thank
a
you.
Seat. So we're going to start with, what did you think you did well?
I think the beginning was good. I was staying on track. I kind of followed what I was thinking. And I could see kind of throughout that beginning kind of phase, the first 30 seconds, mm-hmm. I was hitting the key points that I wanted. And then kind of as it went on, I got a little bit off track, so.
Mm-hmm. So yeah. What are some of the things that you would want to work on?
I really want to tell a story when I incorporate it into the pitch. That way it's easier for people to understand and like relate to, I think, if I can incorporate that in some way, mm-hmm. just to make it a little bit more personal, because it's biotech. It's really hard for people to understand it.
It's boring.
There it is, right?
It is very boring.
Yeah. Super boring.
No, tell them what you really think, Anthony. Muddle.
It is boring.
Okay.
Facts. Tell, story, sell. Mm-hmm. That's a very famous pitch person told me that, and I think that is a good observation. If you want to work a story, and you got 60 seconds, do you think you sold it? You would have said yes. You would have said yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Exactly.
There's work to be done. Well, I will be honest. I'm a little confused. You got me the antibiotic crisis, which I understand enough to be dangerous about, and then the urinary tract. There was quite a bit going on, and I was trying to figure out what you actually were selling. Like,
right.
it's a lot going on here. And plus,
exactly.
I don't think anyone likes to think about urinary catheters either, so we have to address
Good point.
That.
Good point. Let's remove the visual and get to the facts.
Yeah.
All right, William, so what we're going to do next is we're going to meet you in the workshop room, and we're going to do exactly that. We're going to do a little work. We're going to help you craft, and then we'll take it from there. You're going to be a
so
massive
be
success,
ready to
right?
work, all right?
Absolutely,
there we go.
Well, okay. Thank you.
All right.
I really need to work on my storytelling. That's the biggest thing I need to work on while I'm here. But I think today and tomorrow are going to be great for me developing over these next couple of days and really getting my pitch together.
When William was giving his pitch, I felt like William was giving his pitch. And I feel like if I asked William right now what time it is, that he would say, well, in 1792 in Switzerland, that he has so much data and so much science and so much information, it's too much. And if he can just craft that into a story, then I think he can hit a home run.
So what do you think? Like, really?
I think there's a lot of lumps of clay here. There's definitely work to do. I don't know that we have enough time. That's my biggest concern.
I know. I could spend a week with each one of
with
these.
Each one,
we've got a small right? amount of time to do a lot of work.
Exactly.
There's a lot riding on this.
We're going to see,
all
right?
Let's do
all right.
It.
On the next episode of Fix My Pitch.
I feel my way to success.
Without failure, there is no success.
But I wanted to get your guys' opinions to see like what things I should keep in there.
Keep it simple, K-E-I-S. I do expect to see improvements if they take the advice, but they have a lot of work to do.